Scott, we're speaking after the second of two preparation matches against Northern Ireland. How do you reflect on the past week, the training and the matches?
Really good, really positive. Great to work with the new players. Great to involve some young players. Great that one of the players moved up to the full squad, because that's what it's all about. So, yeah, really good week. And two very different games, actually. Two different surfaces and a lot of good things. A lot of things we can improve on, obviously. But I think it's really positive overall.
I think we've seen as many as 14 players make their debut at this level. How much does it excite you working with a full new group of players virtually?
It does. It's really interesting to see that the progression that they make during their time with us. Some of them are here ahead of schedule and can play in the under-21s for the next two cycles, which is fantastic as well. It's our job to really help them and help them, support them, push towards the full squad, and we have to create the right environment, and we also have to make sure that it lives up to its billing. You know, I'm really conscious of that as the coach of the under-21 team. When they come with us, they need to go home thinking, yeah, I really enjoyed that, and they all dream of playing for Scotland like we did, and it has to live up to its billing when they're with us.
Obviously a significant victory for Scotland last night against Ireland. Lots of players who you've worked with. Firstly, how much does it please you seeing players who've been at the under-21s now excelling in Steve's squad? And secondly, with the recent example of Josh Doig, how important is it for the new players about the pathway?
It's really interesting watching them watch the game, you know, in the team hotel, and obviously they can see how close they are, and like the example that you've given the players. It's I think it's very different from how it was in the past. There used to be a bigger gap between the 21s and the full squad, and it took longer, but not anymore. You know, Steve's shown that he's willing to give these players a chance, and it's fantastic to see them doing that.
Obviously, four goals across the two games and lots of chances created. It seems like we have some real attacking players going forward in this age group.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's good to hear you say that. I agree. It's something that we're very conscious of. We feel we've been very organised and very kind of tried to make the team as competitive as we can. But we also recognise we need to go and try and score goals to win games. So we have to get that balance correct.
Obviously, players like Conor Barron and Alex Lowry have been involved before to come back. Do you feel you've got quite an exciting group going into the qualifiers when they start next year?
Yeah, I think it is important to mention that there is a lot of players missing from that are eligible for selection. So that does add to the excitement. We need to pick the right players and hope that everybody's available for selection and bring them together. And I think we will have a very strong team.
Rory, obviously speaking after the second of the two matches against Northern Ireland, how do you reflect on your first week being part of the under-21 squad?
Yeah, I think it's been good. Really good experience for me, being in here with all the boys. I mean, first result obviously was a good result. We're a wee bit disappointed today. I thought we probably deserved more for the game, but we have to deal with it and move on.
From a personal point of view, getting on in both games, your first two appearances for the 21s, despite just being 16, how proud a moment is that for you?
It's a proud moment for me and my family. I mean, it's a lot of trust in the gaffer and the backroom staff to obviously put me on in that, so I'm delighted with it.
Obviously, Ben, you've played with kind of coming through the last few years. How much has it helped having him around as well, the pair of you together?
It's brilliant. Me and Docs have got on well, so it's always good to have a face before you come in, like it's a new group and that. So it was good to have him and as we went on after they became tight. So it was good. The boys are all brilliant.
How have you found the step up in the standard of training, and how much of the more experienced players helped you throughout the week?
No, it's been brilliant. Standard's really high. A lot of first team players in here, so you'd expect the standard to be high, which it is. So it is. It's a good standard in training. They give you wee pointers here and there, but you could have done better. So it is. It's brilliant.
And do you think the fact that Scott Gemmell's put you in, despite you just being 16, shows you a significant level of trust?
I think he's got trust in me so far. I think he shows a lot of belief in me, but he chucked me on with the last couple of minutes to go there, and then obviously on Thursday there, and all, he shows belief in he can trust me, as you said, so it was good.
And finally, you mentioned your family. If you just tell me who was here today and how proud you think they have been over you over the past week?
So just my mum and my dad and my brothers and my pals, so it was good to see all them here back up in Scotland and supporting the team.